This week, we want to talk more about Starship again, because there is some major upheaval going on in Florida. With SpaceX at least temporarily closing down the Cocoa, Florida site and moving all Starship building activities to Boca Chica. So what does this new strategy mean for the future timeline of Starship and Super Heavy? Will we still see Zagu travel around the moon in 2023? Or will this lead to massive delays?
Speaking of delays, we want to take a bit of time today to analyze new developments over at the Artemis program. Now, the new associate administrator of NASA's Human Exploration and Operations Mission Directorate, what a beautiful title, has just been sworn in, and he apparently is quite optimistic about the 2024 target date for the Artemis moon landing. Well, then at least one person is optimistic for that target date. So will NASA really be able to make it by 2024? Let's find out.
So it appears that there are some major strategic shifts going on over at SpaceX. Until not too long ago, there was this internal competition thing going on between the two Starship building sites at Boca Chica, Texas, and the other one at Cocoa, Florida. But now it seems that SpaceX is shifting its strategy in order to fully concentrate on building the Starship Mk3 prototype in Boca Chica as fast as possible. So this basically means that the Cocoa site is being shut down, or better, will be kept in suspended animation. And all activities will now take place at Boca Chica and to some extent at the Launch Pad 39A at Kennedy Space Center. Some Starship building parts are already being transported from Cocoa to Boca Chica, as we can see on these images here. So what does this new strategy mean for the future timeline of Starship and Super Heavy? Well, it appears as if this is the necessary step for SpaceX to undertake, after the Mk1 Starship prototype kind of exploded during a pressurizing test 3 weeks ago. So the new strategy of SpaceX is to speed up the building process of the Mk3 Starship prototype as fast as possible, in order to complete it at record speeds. The first parts for the Mk3 Starship have already arrived at Boca Chica, and work is in full swing here, as we can see. The Cocoa site will certainly remain closed for quite a while now, and the activities in Florida will shift to building the Starship launch mount at Launch Pad 39A at the Kennedy Space Center.
Now, we personally think that this was a wise strategic decision, a smart move. The Mk2 Starship that was being built in Cocoa was based on the Mk1 design anyways, so it would probably have suffered the same problems as the Mk1 and was thus probably not viable anymore. Now, this means that Super Heavy construction will not take place in Cocoa anymore, and that the Starship Mk4 prototype that would have been built in Cocoa will be scrapped. This means that SpaceX is focusing all its resources to get the Mk3 Starship prototype flight ready in Boca Chica as soon as possible, which we think is a very smart strategic move considering the circumstances. And now, of course, the big question: will this alter the Starship timeline for the next few years? Will this have a dramatic impact? The Mk3 prototype will be engineered even better, incorporating all the lessons learned, making it as light as possible, and it will be already an orbit-ready vehicle. The merging of the Cocoa and Boca Chica team and focusing all their efforts at Boca Chica will probably lead to an acceleration of the timeline, fascinatingly. Because don't forget that only a few years ago, SpaceX had some major setbacks with the Falcon 9 explosions back in 2015 and 2016. And now Falcon 9 is super proven and trustworthy and flies time and time again, only 3 years later. So this is the beautiful thing with SpaceX. If they make mistakes, it actually accelerates their timelines. So don't worry, we still will see Yuzaku circling the moon in 2023 with the Dear Moon mission, and this here will happen also not so long afterwards, probably in 2024.
Talking about 2024, we all know that fateful date by heart now. It sounds like a really cool date from an 80s sci-fi movie, but weirdly, it's only a few years away. We've heard it so often, we've even started dreaming about 2024.
Thank you.
now the new Associate Administrator of NASA's Human Exploration and Operations Mission Directorate, Douglas Loverro, probably he himself cannot even remember that title, thinks that despite the odds not being in NASA's favor, the chances for NASA being able to put astronauts back to the moon by that very date are actually not so bad. So on the 3rd of December, Loverro introduced himself to NASA at their headquarters in Washington, D.C. During that event, this poor guy had to answer some tough questions from NASA workers about the feasibility of the 2024 moon landing, the possibility that funding issues would delay or even cancel the Artemis program, and the future of NASA's long-delayed and over-budget SLS, also known as the Standard, I mean the Space Launch System. Fascinatingly, Loverro seemed very confident that NASA can meet the 2024 goal. Now we don't know if this guy is the best poker player on this planet with the best poker face, or if he really means it. In this meeting, Jim Bridenstine was also present and said something very interesting about the SLS.
Now he said that he disagrees with the projected $1.5 to $2 billion launch costs of SLS, although he didn't provide any argumentation as proof, and that there's actually not really a competition between SLS and commercial rockets. He's right on that, however, probably in a different way than he would like. There is indeed no competition between SLS and Starship, because Starship just totally obliterates SLS, like in every metric. In every single metric. We actually did a quite little fun comparison between Starship and SLS in this video here, showing that Starship is actually 1 million times more efficient, at least 1 million times more efficient than SLS. So yeah, he's really right about that. There really is no competition. Now, interestingly, Loverro added that NASA is going to need every possible rocket launch capability, whether through government funding as SLS or through entrepreneurial and commercial funding, such as for New Glenn and Starship. New Glenn and Starship in one sentence? And he even mentions New Glenn before Starship? New Glenn before Starship? Before? This, in our opinion, shows that those guys haven't done any bit of research about the state of current commercial rockets. If you mention New Glenn before Starship and put it into the same sentence as if it was the same thing, then you have no freaking clue about the capabilities of these launch systems. Because one is only fancy CGI renderings, and we haven't seen anything, any prototype flying as of now, whereas the other, we have seen functioning prototypes. One has already flown 150 meters high, and the other, okay, has exploded, but still is on the way to be built right now before our eyes. We can see it being built all the time. So how can you compare vaporware with something that is being shown to us, like we can see it being built in front of our eyes? And as things are progressing, the Mark III prototype will probably reach orbit already in late 2020, whereas New Glenn, what have we seen of New Glenn? Only CGI renderings. And this guy actually compares New Glenn and Starship as if it was the same thing. Not to mention the 3 times higher payload capability to low Earth orbit of Starship compared to New Glenn. And of course, not to mention the probably 10, nay 100 times probably higher payload capability of Starship for landing cargo on the moon as compared to New Glenn. Why, Loverro? Why? Why do you mention those two things in one sentence as if it's the same thing? It's not the same thing. It's not the same thing, Loverro. It's not the same thing. It's like comparing a Tesla Model S to a Renault Twizy. You don't compare those two things. You don't put them in one sentence, Loverro. You don't put them into one sentence. I have to calm down a bit. I fortunately don't transform into Hulk, but if Jixuan would have heard that, she would have transformed into Hulk for sure. Okay, but we should see the positive side. At least he acknowledges the existence of commercial rocket alternatives to SLS. So that's already better than nothing, we assume.
Although, of course, he and Bridenstine had to reiterate that currently the SLS is the only flight-ready option that NASA has. Oh, really? This doesn't look quite flight-ready to us. But at least Loverro seems to be open-minded for for commercial alternatives. And he said that NASA has to become more flexible and open-minded for changing their strategy in the upcoming years in order to incorporate commercial rockets into the Artemis program, if necessary. We think it will be very necessary, indeed. So that wording already sounds pretty good to us, where we think that after an unmanned cargo moon landing of Starship in 2021, and after an unmanned moon round trip with Starship in 2022, NASA will incorporate Starship and Super Heavy more and more into their Artemis program, until at some point, they will hopefully completely charter Starship to bring their astronauts back to the moon. The same way they are chartering Crew Dragon to ferry astronauts to the ISS beginning next year. We would be really happy to see it develop that way.
So what do you think about this Loverro guy? Is he maybe a bit too optimistic that NASA can make it to the moon by 2024? Now, if they would completely ditch SLS for Starship, we would be very optimistic, honestly. But like this, we don't know.
In any case, it will be very exciting.
It will be.
And what do you think about the Cocoa Set being shut down now? Do you think it's a good strategy from SpaceX in order to finish the Mk3 Starship prototype as soon as possible?
I think it's a quite good strategy, honestly. So tell us what you think in the comment section, because as you know, we are always happy to engage in conversations with you. We don't just say that, we actually also do it.
And we would be very happy if you would subscribe to our channel, because we regularly upload 2 videos per week and always tell you our honest opinions on the latest developments in space.
Yes, 100% correct what she says. So see you again next time.